Hey, what's up, everybody? This is Charles Sabanis. I want to welcome you guys to another episode of the Dreamers Pro Show. We cover everything from sports, hot topics, classic debates, entertainment. I'm going to give you guys a fresh perspective on things. And I always see them. And today, we got a hell of a show for you guys. Before we get into it, please make sure you like the video and sub to the channel. Also, if you want today's full show before it drops on YouTube, we have it linked in the comment section below with the Dreamers Pro podcast. Let me get into this topic here. Now, this is a topic that I just find to be immensely entertaining. So yesterday, we was all relaxing. And a bit of news broke. A big piece of news broke. And what was this big news? The big news was that it had been confirmed that I think in May or June or something like that, or April, May or June or something like that, or July, one of those months, that Mike Tyson, Iron Mike, is going to be boxing with Jake Paul. And the minute I heard that, the first thought that came to my mind was, what is the sport of boxing turning into? Like, what in the world is it turning into at this point? That was the first thing. The second thing I thought is, what is this? Like, what are we supposed to make of this? I'm not a huge boxing fan, but I've seen my fair share of Mike Tyson fights. Actually, the two most enjoyable boxers for me to watch that I've seen is Mike Tyson and Roy Jones Jr. Roy Jones was just, he's incredible, right? But what do we all know about Mike Tyson? Ain't nobody playing with Mike Tyson. Nobody is playing. I was in the UK recently, and I was at a restaurant/bar or whatever. Let me say like a cafe, whatever. So I was drinking my coffee and I'm paying. The guy next to me, I forgot what his job was. And I was talking to the guy at the bar, and he was asking me, "You're going to watch this fight? You're going to watch that fight?" And I think he was asking about Anthony Joshua. And who was he supposed to be fighting? I think it was Deontay Wilder or somebody. I don't remember. I was like, "Yeah, I'm not sure." Or Francis Ngannou or something like that. And I brought up Mike Tyson. And I was like, yo, I was watching some videos of Mike Tyson training Francis Ngannou. And I was trying to look for the videos on my phone. And I was like, yo, Mike Tyson looked dangerous as hell, even at this age. I'm like, he looks dangerous. And we were talking, and I was like, I would rather get hit by Francis Ngannou than get hit by Mike Tyson. And all of us dudes talking there, we all came to the conclusion that the last person any of us would want to face is Mike Tyson. Anybody watching this video here, that's not maybe a special martial artist or something, just some dude that will say he would be willing to fight Mike Tyson, waste no time talking to these. Nobody trying to fight Mike Tyson. As a matter of fact, we put up a poll on our channel. I was like, who would you rather fight, Mike Tyson or Deontay Wilder? We put it up yesterday and I wrote, I'll take Wilder. Y'all can have Mike. 70%, listen to this. 77% said, give me Deontay Wilder. I'll take my chances with him. Only 23% said, give me Mike Tyson. Nobody playing with Mike Tyson. Even at the age of 57, you're not playing with Mike. Like, let's just cut it out. And Mike Tyson still got that look in his eyes like he could snap, right? So this news comes out, and I post another poll before that, and I wrote, who wins this fight if it's not rigged? Because it's so ridiculous that something must be going on here. And I wrote, who wins this fight if it's not rigged? Of the 9,800 people that have voted, 91% of them said it's Mike Tyson. The other nine, I don't know, maybe they must be trolling. And I went to go look up Mike Tyson's record. And I looked at Mike Tyson's record, and Mike Tyson has a 50-6 record and has 44 knockouts. Jake Paul has a 9-1 record and 6 knockouts, but has never fought a boxer, a real boxer, even at the advanced age of Mike Tyson. And all of us are up here thinking, what in the hell is actually going on? Well, apparently, we're not the only ones that's thinking this, because this morning I came across an article from Front Office Sports with the following headline. Jake Paul, Mike Tyson Netflix fight raises questions about oversight. Jake Paul and Mike Tyson will face off in the ring this summer in a boxing match streamed live on Netflix from AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. The streamer announced Thursday. Netflix is co-promoting the event with the Most Valuable Promotions, co-founded by Paul in 2021. The 27-year-old social media personality and rising boxing competitor will face the 57-year-old former world heavyweight champion who last fought in 20. I'm very much looking forward to stepping into the ring with Jake Paul at the AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas, Tyson said in a statement. It's a full circle moment that will be beyond thrilling to watch as I started him off in his boxing journey on the undercard of my fight with Roy Jones, and now I plan to finish him. The reference to the 2020 fight with Jones, which was contested in California under special rules meant to protect the frail combatants, raises a key issue here, which is why the fight is allowed to happen at all. In most states, boxing and other combat sports are regulated by a commission and enforces regulations meant to, among other things, protect competitors. Notable examples where that didn't seem to be the case exclude boxer James Tony being licensed in Massachusetts to fight former UFC champion Randy Couture, despite never having competed in MMA at all. And CM Punk, who has also never fought MMA, being licensed to fight for the UFC in Ohio. The article then continues on. In the Lone Star State, fighting is overseen by the Texas Department of Licensing and Regulation, which is not known for zealous enforcement of the codes governing combat sports. These include a requirement that fighters pass a pre-fight medical exam showing them fit for competition, a subjective standard, but even so, one it's difficult to imagine being met by Mike Tyson, who has a history of head trauma and suffers from a nerve pain known as sciatica, which can occasionally leave him needing to use a wheelchair. As for now, the department has yet to issue any sort of approval for the fight because it has not been asked to do so, it said. The promoter has requested to have an event that day, but we have not received any proposed cards and thus have no details about what they are planning. All bouts are subject to review and approval by TDLR, a spokesperson from the department tells Front Office Sports. So you heard what the article had to say there. Well, I guess we're just going to have to wait and see what happens, huh? Because I don't even know what to make of this situation here. I expect Mike Tyson to win. But this bit of information here, I was not even privy to it prior to even shooting this particular show here. I guess we have to wait and see. I think if this is a normal standard fight, I think Mike Tyson is going to knock this guy into the next galaxy. Because we're talking about Mike Tyson here. Even at the age of 57, nobody watching this video is going to want to jump inside a ring with Mike Tyson. I don't care who the hell you are. So I guess we have to wait and see. But what is going on in the world today? That's all I have to say. These are my thoughts. Whatever you guys think, leave your thoughts in the comments and we catch you on the next show. Peace.